Now we're talking about real power based on the Fourier series expansion terms. For real power, we need voltage and current. So we have our voltage waveform, and we can write it out in the Fourier series expansion using the RMS terms here. And for the phase shift, we're actually changing it to alpha 1 for the voltage. And for the current, it's the same form where we're using the RMS values. Remember, this is our DC component, our fundamental term, and then our higher order harmonic terms. And for current, we're using beta as our phase shift because these phase shifts may be different. For real power, we're looking at the difference between the two. So we're actually going to define, in this case, phi of n is going to be defined as alpha of n minus beta of n. So just like when we calculated power, it's the phase shift between the voltage and the current waveform, but this is broken down for each of the individual components. To calculate real power, we know P is real power, which is equal to Valerie in our power transfer analogy, and that's the same as average power. So when we write that out, we can take the mean value of the voltage times the current waveform. We have two infinite series, and we're going to multiply those together, similar to the calculation that we did for the RMS, we'll find that there's going to be a lot of simplifications for this. But let's start with this basic form and go through each of the terms. Let's start with just the average. And now we need to multiply the voltage times the current. Let's start with the first term of the voltage and multiply it by each term of the current. V0 times I0, that's going to be a non-zero value here. And then we would go on to multiply V0 times this sine component and then all of the other sines. Remember, we're taking the average or mean, which means that the average or mean of a sine is always going to be 0. So we're just going to call this times all these other ones, we're going to call that others. Then we can move on to the next term. So this term can then be the fundamental for the voltage can be multiplied by this. Because there's a sine, it's going to be 0. We're going to count that as others. Then we're going to multiply these two together. These will come out as something non-zero. So 2V1I1 sine of omega t plus alpha 1 and sine multiplied by sine omega t plus beta 1. We're going to leave that as is, and we're going to then go on to multiply this by the higher order terms. Because the frequencies here are not the same, the average of all of those values are also going to be 0. So we're going to consider that others. Let's go on to the third term here. So multiply this by DC value, because it's a sine, it's going to go to 0. Multiply this by a different frequency, again, it's going to go to 0. And multiply it by the same frequency, we're going to get a component out of that. So we're going to get 2V2 I2 sine of 2 omega t plus alpha 2 sine of omega t plus 2 omega t plus beta 2. And then we're going to multiply that by higher terms. Again, the frequencies are different, so they're all going to go to 0, others. And so on. The important terms that are going to come out after we take the integral are going to relate to these terms. I'm not going to do all the math again, but if you go back to the video explaining the calculation for AC power, you'll get a very similar relationship. You have to use trigonometric identities to change this around, and you can solve for the equation. Once we do all the math for that out, we will find that the power can be broken down into each of the components. So we'll get voltage V0 I0 plus V1 I1, and we're actually going to get cosine of the phase shift. Remember, this is between the phases of the voltage and the current. 1 plus V2 I2 cosine of V2, and so on. We can make this term, call this term P0. So this is the power for just the DC component, and that by definition is V0 I0. And we can call this one P1, this one P2. Essentially, this is the power for each of the individual frequencies. So this would be the fundamental, this would be the second harmonic, third, fourth, and so on. The general equation we can write for this is P of n, so power for the nth harmonic, is equal to Vn, In, and then cosine of the phase shift between those two for that component. So remember, if you want to find Valerie, the real power, based on the Fourier series expansion, you will have the voltage and current in the expanded form using the RMS values of each of the individual components. And you'll find that the power will also be broken up into its individual components. And first starting with the DC value here, and then each of the components ahead of that. And the values you need to know are the RMS values of each of the components and the phase shift between each of the harmonic components.